Everyone, let's learn about the maxim of injurious any damnum, right? This means that injury without damage. So, the violation of a legal right is actionable, but the actual damage is not considered relevant, which means that in order to constitute a tort, there must be a violation of a legal right. There may be a damage or may not be a damage, right? So, there are two cases. One which we are going to discuss, one is an international scenario and another one is an Indian scenario. In international scenario, the case was of Ashby versus White, right? So what happened in this case? Ashby was a plaintiff and Mr. White was a defendant. So defendant prevent plaintiff from exercising his right to vote, although the plaintiff was a legitimate citizen of the constituency and also was a qualified voter, right? But the candidate whom the plaintiff want to vote for won the election, right? So in this scenario, if you would see, there was a violation of a legal right of the plaintiff to vote, right? But there was no damage as such, as the candidate won the election. So we learned that in order to constitute a tort, there must be a violation of a legal right. And in this scenario, there was a violation of a legal right, and therefore the court has given the damages to the plaintiff. Another case is an Indian scenario, which is of Bhim Singh versus State of Jammu and Kashmir. In this scenario, what happened that the defendant was basically the police and basically the state was there, and the plaintiff was a MLA in the State of Jammu and Kashmir. So the defendant basically wrongfully detained the plaintiff and not allowed them to vote in the parliamentary session, and because of this, the plaintiff's legal right to vote was violated, and therefore the damages has been awarded to the plaintiff.